So for me as an entrepreneur, what are the type of design types that I need to care about?
So my specialty is interaction design. So as you probably guessed from me saying task, task, task over and over again in the
Right.
last few minutes, that's where I bias towards. So kind of we focus on trying to understand users and behaviors, think about the types of things they want to do and how to best fulfill them. But that's just one of the specializations. There's many. Other very common ones are visual design.
Right.
They focus on everything that the user sees while they're engaging with your experience.
Is there like colors and stuff like that, or?
Colors is one, but it's also things like layout, like scale, any iconography that's there, everything from fonts and upward, anything that becomes a pixel in that piece of software.
Right.
Visual design tries to concentrate on that. And there's thousands of small decisions that go into that that is their specialization. Then there's also things like motion design. This is a newer, focus for design in many cases. And they're concerned with how anything animates, big or small, to give the user a sense that their feedback is being heard and that the system's responding to it. And just to kind of bring the product to life a little bit and make it feel like it's something that they're really kind of engaging in this push and pull with.
You can also stress things with animation, right?
Oh, absolutely. Animation is a great way to tell the user where their attention should be focused at any given time. And then there's other specializations. There's things like industrial design, the design of physical objects.
Right.
There's sound design. There's kind of brand or print design, and so on and so on and so on. Anything that you're doing on this product that has some decision that needs to be made, there's probably a whole discipline of design that can help you make that decision.
So what you're basically telling me is that I need to hire 8 people?
Yes. Wait, no. You can get by with fewer.
Okay.
So I know most small teams just don't have that capacity to hire
Right.
all the specializations. So the good news is that in my experience, most designers are hybrids. They might identify as being one of those specializations, but they often have familiarity to varying degrees with the other fields of the discipline. So what's important to keep in mind when you hire is kind of have a sense of what your expectations are going to be. Like, what are you going to need out of this designer? Do you need interaction and visual? Do they need to work on your brand for you? And make sure that the capabilities are in the people that you hire. Or make sure that they're comfortable directing the work of contractors who might be able to kind of augment the capabilities that they lack.
How do they know if they're any good?
Wow, that's a good question. I think the best way to judge a designer is from their work. So you should certainly ask for work samples. You should look for the portfolio. You should find out what kind of things get them excited about design. Are they like very focused on the user and on simplicity? Are they a designer who can come in and kind of give more pizzazz, a little sex appeal, a little gloss to the product? There's appeal to kind of having all of those types of people involved with the work.